Oh, good timing. I was just about to head to your workshop.
Oh? What's up, Lias?
I just wanted to find out your schedule so I could work around it to take care of some things at the castle.
Oh yeah, you have your soldier duties too, huh? I feel bad making you look after me all the time.
Don't worry about that. Rufus says I have no business being a soldier if I can't even one princess.
Rufus said that? I knew he was really tough on me, but I guess he's pretty strict with you, too.
Oh, it's no big deal. I just don't think he'll ever respect me if I don't show him how hard I can really work.
Princess, so this is where you were hiding. I have some more information regarding the task you were assigned.
Well, I'd better get going then. See you, Meruru.
Lias! Lias, you could have at least said hello to Rufus.
I've been so tough on him. I suppose he doesn't want to see me. Perhaps he has no love for me anymore.
You think so? Whenever you're not around, it seems like you're all he ever talks about. Last time he was at the workshop, the first thing he asked was if you'd mentioned him or anything.
I see. Perhaps he's so worried about his performance he's lost focus. I'll have to talk with him later.
What? No! I mean, I don't think that's what he meant! Hey! And now he's gone! Those two are just constantly misunderstanding each other. Why can't they just be more open?
Thank you.
All done! Great! It came out just like the recipe said! You're so great, Miss Totri! You make these complicated recipes look so simple! I still have so much to learn! Oh, don't worry. Keep on practicing your synthesizing, and everything will just keep on getting easier. So stay motivated. Without putting in the actual effort, nothing will ever change.
I hope so.
Even with you, there were a few times where things got a little choppy. If that was me, I would have freaked out and ruined the whole thing. Oh, synthesizing this particular item is always like that. It's not so bad once you get the hang of it.
I still have a long way to go, though.
Don't rush it. Just concentrate on what you can do day by day. That's how I learned alchemy.
Okay! Miss Totri, you're such an amazing alchemist, even though you're still so young. I really admire you.
Well, it's nice to hear that. But is it okay for you to think that way? You are a princess, after all.
Huh? What do you mean?
It's nothing. Never mind. All right, Meruru. Keep working hard to become a full-fledged alchemist.
Yes, ma'am! I'm getting really fired up now!
Just keep on stirring. Just give it a little swirly-swirly.
Okay. Swirly-swirly... Swirly-swirly.
Okay, now, hold your breath, push your entire soul out into your arms, and give it another swirly-swirly.
Got it!
Subtle difference there.
Really?
pat it and give it another swirly-swirly.
With my smile?
Yep. Smiling at this stage is very important. Just imagine the amazing item you're creating and find that energy.
Okay. Swirly, swirly.
Wow. Perfect. Totori, you're a natural.
Thank you very much, but am I allowed to breathe now?
Oh, I totally forgot. Your face is changing color. Are you okay?
When I first started out, I was so happy anytime Miss Rorona gave me a compliment. She must have been really great at explaining stuff. She was your teacher after all, and you're amazing!
Huh? Well, I had to rely a lot on instinct. Otherwise, I never would have understood her teaching method. But it's definitely thanks to her that I am where I am today. She is truly wonderful, without a doubt.
Wow! I want Miss Rorona to teach me someday, too!
Sure, Meruru. You just might get a chance to become Miss Rorona's second apprentice.
Why do you have that distant look in your eye all of a sudden?
No reason. For now, just focus on learning alchemy by following my instructions.
Yeah, yeah! I'll do my best!
Thank you.
explore the Eastern Lands. I should talk to Rufus about it when I report in.
This outpost is most impressive. It's small, but strongly built. It can withstand just about any assault. Hello, Princess of Arles. It's been too long.
Uncle Geo! What are you doing here?
I came to see how your work has been going, and your training. You've come a long way.
You should have told me you were going to visit. Is it really okay for a king like you to just go wandering around?
A valid point, but my kingship is in the past now. Arland has become a republic, you know. I have many skilled subordinates, so even in my absence, the government will always run smooth. But how about you? I heard you've taken the lead on the plan to develop your kingdom.
It's just like you said. I was able to come this far because I've lots of great people supporting me.
I see. So we're more alike than I'd imagined.
Yeah, maybe. But who is this with you? I feel like we've met before, but...
Oh, I'm sorry. I haven't introduced myself. My name is Esty. I'm here to observe Arles on behalf of Arland. I'll be directing all general business related to the development and settlement of Arles' kingdom. But really, my main job is simply to look after our wandering lord here.
Hey, come on, that's not very nice. I'm just fulfilling my duties the only way I know how.
Well, let's leave it at that. If you two will excuse me, I'll talk with you again, Princess Meruru.
Miss Esty, please, call me Meruru. Like my Uncle Geo here? I really don't like formality.
Thank you. Okay then, Meruru. We'll speak again when we both have a little more free time.
So how long will you be in Arles, Uncle?
I've been stuck behind a desk so long, I'm completely out of shape. I'll stay here until I feel I'm back on track.
You never change. Anyway, Father's been concerned about you too.
I know. I'll pay him a visit once I get to town. It'll be nice to reminisce about the good old times.
I can imagine. Oh, and come visit my workshop when you arrive, too. Promise me?
Right there! Yes! I'm feeling pretty good!
get me! Do your thing, Chim! That was easy! Let's keep it up!
My training is paying off.
Are you?
What? I could ask you the same question.
I heard this was Toturia Helmold's workshop.
Toturia? Oh, Miss Toturi! Yes! Please wait here! Teacher! You have a visitor! Okay, just a second! I'll be right there!
Teacher, are you like her student or something?
Yes! I'm Meruru Lince Raid Arles, apprentice to Miss Toturi.
Meruru Lince? Isn't that the name of this kingdom's princess?
Oh, yeah, that's me. It's probably hard to believe when you see me in clothes like these, though.
Wow, this place sure is amusing. An alchemist princess. Even a genius like me never could have imagined that.
Hey, hey, Esty, Esty! I want to say hi, too!
I told you to stop calling me that! Ugh, whatever. Anyway, I suppose I should introduce myself. I'm Astrid, the amazing alchemist who happens to be your master's master's master.
Rorona. Rorona! What a cute name!
But I feel like I've heard it somewhere before.
Sorry to keep you waiting. What can I do for you?
It's Rorona,
and my teacher's teacher's teacher, Miss,
Astrid? Miss Astrid? What are you doing here, and
did you forget me, Toto? I'm Rorona.
Did you say Rorona?
Oh my, it can't be.
Whether or not it can't be, it is. This is Rorona, without a doubt. Of course, she's a kid now.
Rorona's here!
What happened to you?
Meruru, this is Miss Rorona. My teacher I was telling you about.
Hey, Miss Totori, calm down! Just take a deep breath.
Deep breath.
Huh? Okay.
Delightful response. Exactly the kind of reaction I was hoping for when I created the Potion of Youth.
Potion of Youth? Now that you mention it, Miss Astrid, you look younger too.
The plan was for Rorona to return to her ideal age, much like myself. Alright, I suppose I should explain what happened from the beginning.
Master, this hurts. Palm's cheeks were not designed to stretch this way.
It is the will of the Grand Master. Please, bear with it.
Stretch! Stretch!
I see. So that potion made Miss Rorona the way she is. How old is she now?
If I had to guess, I'd say around 8 years old. She was supposed to be 14. Also, the potion's effect is permanent.
Why would you make something like that? And what's so special about being 14?
Do you really have to ask? Who wants a Rorona in her 30s? Not me, that's for sure. So, I came up with a potion to roll her back to 14 years old. My personal favorite age. Forever. I drank it myself to test the results, and it worked fine. But with Rorona, I guess I got a little carried away with the idea of making her 14 again.
So that's why Miss Rorona got so much younger, huh?
That's the gist of it, yeah. The worst part isn't how she looks, but what's going on inside that head of hers.
Oh, so it's not just her body that got younger?
Right. It looks like her memory's been totally erased too. Although she does seem to remember people pretty well. So the final result is that Rorona turned into exactly what she looks like. A dumb little girl.
Miss Totori? Is it just me? Or is this lady talking crazy talk?
I don't really know what to say. Except that it's just how Ms. Astrid is.
Nothing is crazy. How can a student of alchemy not understand the utter splendor of an experiment like this? Oh, by the way, so you're Totori's apprentice, right? And also this kingdom's princess?
Ah, that's right.
But I kind of forced her to let me be her apprentice.
I see. Okay, I can work with this. You'll be a pretty good resource, I think.
Huh? What are you talking about?
Oh no, I was just thinking out loud. Don't worry about it.
So I'm assuming you had a reason for coming here?
Oh yeah, good point. Rorona begged me to come see you. I just couldn't stand that squealing of hers. So now, I'm depending on you.
Did I miss something? What am I being dependent on for?
Well, the potion itself was a success, and I thought things might be okay, but she's just too much for me to handle. I've been too busy babysitting to come up with an antidote. I need to dump her on, bless someone with her. And then I remembered that you existed. It occurred to me that you'd gone off to some distant country.
Miss Rorona was supposed to come here, but you said she was involved in a big experiment. Wait, don't tell me.
Correct. And I must say, that experiment ended with results far beyond my expectations. But no need to fear. I have a way to fix her. Although, the ingredients are pretty rare, and the synthesis is a pain. Even if we start now, it'll take some time. So, to return Rorona back to normal as soon as possible, your cooperation is quite indispensable.
Back to normal, huh? That's good, right? I'll look after her with you. Right, Rorona? Huh? What is it, Rorona? You're wearing a crown. Are you a princess? Oh, yep. Sure am. Wow. It's so cute.
Rorona and Meruru are already fast friends. This is gonna go splendidly.
She's a child now, but I'm not sure she's changed all that much. You can really turn her back, right?
Of course. I wouldn't be here asking for your help if I couldn't.
Understood. As long as you promise you can fix her, I'll look after Miss Rorona.
I'm glad you're so understanding. I'll leave you with the two Homs to make things easier with Rorona. They're excellent helpers. They can do your chores and even assist with alchemy. Ask them for more details. Okay, Homs. You'll be staying here from now on to help take care of Rorona. Do your best, okay?
Of course, Grandmaster.
Great! Now I can finally relax. I mean, focus on my research. Well, see ya!
Oh, she's gone. I wonder if she can really turn Miss Rorona back to normal. I guess we'll just have to wait and see.
Totri! Rorona's hungry!
I'm running low on energy as well. Could you please provide us with something to eat?
You came to Arland by carriage, right? The food you brought with you wasn't enough?
Correct. The amount of food loaded on the carriage was enough for all occupants. However, the Grand Master wound up eating all of our food, so we ran out a day early. We have not eaten since last night.
Oh, really? Then I'll go fix something up right now. Just wait here and keep an eye on Miss Rorona.
The workshop's way more exciting now. I feel like things are gonna get pretty interesting around here.